Let's listen to the music. Flowers from Miley Cyrus. Do you know this song?
We were good, we were cold.
Wow. Kind of dream. Nice tune.
Be so. We were right till we weren't. Built a home and watched.
It makes me wanna dance.
I didn't wanna leave. I didn't wanna lie. Started to cry, but then
okay, you guys, it's your boy, and today we're gonna talk about two amazing countries, Indonesia and China. These two places are totally different in so many ways, but they both have some seriously cool things going on. So let's dive in and check out what daily life is like in both Indonesia and China. Yeah, listen to the music again. Whoa. Okay, first up, we've got Indonesia. This place is known for its stunning beaches, lush rainforests, and rich cultural heritage. Life in Indonesia is a mix of traditional and modern cultures, with people living in big cities and small villages. Wow. And the living cost in Indonesia is relatively low compared to other Southeast Asian countries. I'm making it a popular destination for tourists, of course. Yeah. Next, we've got China. This place has a rich history and cultural heritage, with a civilization that dates back over 5,000 years. Life in China is fast-paced, with people living in big cities like Beijing, Shanghai, and Hong Kong. The living cost in China varies depending on the city, with some cities being more expensive than others. Music again. So what sets Indonesia and China apart from each other? For starters, the official language in Indonesia is Indonesian, while in China is Mandarin. Indonesia has a tropical climate, while China has a range of climates from subtropical to subarctic. And the two countries also have different religious beliefs, with majority of Indonesians being Muslim and the majority of Chinese being either Buddhist or Taoist. But when I was in China before, I always asked some friends there, what is your religion? They, most of them answer, I have no religion. I don't believe in God, of course. So I think most of Chinese people, maybe are atheists, maybe, yeah. And when it comes to cultural differences, there are a few do's and don'ts to keep in mind. In Indonesia, it's common to remove your shoes when entering someone's home. In China, who's that? Okay. In China, it's considered polite to bring a small gift when visiting someone's home. In Indonesia, it's also important to dress modestly, especially when visiting a mosque to prayer. In China, it's considered disrespectful to point your chopsticks, you know, directly at someone. Yeah, it's very impolite. So there you have it. Both Indonesia and China are two amazing countries with their own unique cultures and ways of life. Whether you're into their rich history, stunning landscapes, or fascinating people, these two countries are definitely worth checking out. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next video. Music again. Woo. See ya.